Working on a weekend like usual. Way off in the deep end like usual. Niggas swear they passed us, they doing too much. Haven't done my taxes, I'm too turned up. Virgil got a paddock on my wrist going nuts. Niggas caught me slipping once, okay, so what? Someone hit your block up, I tell you if it was us. Man, a house in Rosewood, this shit too plush. Say my day's a number, but I keep waking up. Know you see my text, baby, please say something. Wine by the glass, your man a cheapskate, huh? Niggas gotta move on my release day, huh? Bitch, this is fame, not clout. I don't even know what that's about, watch your mouth. Baby, got an ego twice the size of the crib. I can never tell a shit, it is what it is. Said what I had to and
what's up, y'all? It's your girl Tiana, and I'm back with another video. And as y'all can see by the title, I'm going to be doing a hair tutorial. But before I get started with this video, make sure y'all like, comment, and subscribe to my channel for more videos. Let's get into this video. Okay, as y'all can see, I have already prepped my hair. I have put on my cap, and I have glued it down with my Got to Be Glue Blasting Free Spray. And this is how it looks. Y'all can get this from the beauty supply store. I'm not sure what else they sell this at, but I always get this from the beauty supply store, y'all. So I sprayed my cap, and at the front, I did make sure I put some Got to Be Glue styling gel on there, and you can get this from the same exact place. So yeah, and I've already cut my cap and all that good stuff. So today I'm going to be applying my lace front wig. This is some box braids, plaits, whatever you want to call it. I did order this wig off of Etsy. It's E-T-S-Y, Etsy. I will be leaving the link down below in the description box so that y'all can order. And they have plenty of styles on there. They have the knotless plaits. They have the box plaits. They have pretty much everything you can name when it comes to braids. And they also have, you know, regular lace front wigs up there. So y'all check them out. Like I said, I will be leaving the link in the description box down below. Y'all wanna see it? So yeah, y'all, the only thing I'm scared about is it being too heavy for my head, because it is pretty heavy. I'm not even gonna lie, with these box plaits, they are kind of heavy. But the person that did this wig did an awesome job. Awesome, y'all, like a great job. So as you can see, let's see. I'm gonna show y'all the back because I know I'm not gonna be able to show y'all once I put it on. But yeah, the back, you just have the cap. And it also has a band on it, y'all, so that it'll fit snug to y'all heads. Okay, and I have not tried this wig on yet, so I guess I'm gonna go ahead and apply it to my hair and try to, you know, see how it fits. Not gonna lie, y'all, it fits pretty snug. I thought it was gonna be real heavy, but it's not that heavy. Which I love. It's not that heavy. I thought it was gonna be real bad, y'all, but your girl already feeling this, y'all. It ain't even applied. And as y'all can see, the lace, of course, it go from ear to ear. And right here on this part, they left out, they put a little braid right here. Of course, y'all know that it's for your baby hairs. Of course, you can customize your baby hairs however you want. So yes, y'all, I'm already feeling this. I ain't even got home. Oh my God, I love this. Love it, love it, love it. She did her thing. Yes. And I did braid this at the end because what I am going to do is dip the ends in hot water because I kind of want it crinkly, if you know what I mean. Too much do. I mean, I will do straight ends if it's like bone straight, but I feel like I want crinkly ends for these, y'all. Yeah, I'm really, 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 really feeling this. Okay, so now that I know how it looks and it's not gonna be super heavy on my head, I'm just going to go ahead and take this off. Okay, so with this, of course, this is not, the lace is not, you know, the color of my scalp. It's a little lighter. So what I'm going to do is bleach the knots. Okay, so what I mean by bleach the knots, y'all, I'm going to be tinting my lace with this tinted lace spray. And this is the color dark brown. They have this in other colors, but I want to say I got the medium. This was the middle color. Because the other color was, let me see, this one is dark brown. The other color, what was the other color? Y'all, I forgot. But just know it was darker than this, and I didn't want it too dark because I do want it to look like my scalp. So yeah. And let me show y'all how the lace is. She did her thing. Okay, so this is how the lace looks, y'all. And this is how the bottom part looks. Got the band. I do feel like I probably need to tighten my band some because I have a pea head, so yeah. Okay, now that I tinted the lace, I'm going to show y'all how it looks. It looks natural. If y'all can see that, but it looks really good, y'all. Okay, so what I'm about to do so that it won't rub off, I'm going to be spraying some of this Got to Be Glue Blasting Freezing Spray on top of that so that it won't rub off. Okay, and I'm going to let that dry. Okay, now that I tinted the lace, I'm going to be going back in with my Got to Be Glue Gel. And I'm going to be putting that on the front part of my cap. Okay, so I'm gonna just let this get tacky a little bit, and then I'm gonna go in and do another layer of this Got to Be Glue. But what I want to say is, I used to use the Ghost Bond glue to lay down my frontals, but it started breaking me out, and then it burnt my forehead right up in here on both sides of my forehead. And at first, I was like, first it just felt irritating. Like it would itch and, you know, just, it was just really irritating. So as I kept wearing it, I noticed that when I took off my wig that last time, I noticed it burned me. Like it really burned me bad. So I stopped using it and I went back to Got to Be Glue. So if y'all ever been burned by any lace glue or anything, comment down below in the comments, because I'm thinking that it's just me. But if there is a glue out there that don't do all that, y'all comment down below and let me know which one, because I need to know. And with this Got to Be Glue, it's awesome and everything, but once you start sweating, because it's a gel, once you start sweating or getting, or just get it wet, you know, it's a wrap. It's gonna lift up. So comment down below and let me know if there are any other lace glue that y'all tried, because I need to know. Okay, and once the glue turns clear, that's when you know you're ready to apply your weave. Alright y'all, so what I did was put my scarf on just to make sure everything is laid flat. And I will come back to cut the lace. So I am back and I'm all done with applying the wig, and as y'all can see, I have already did my baby hairs. So I just want to say I love this freaking wig, y'all. Like, I really love this. Y'all, look how natural this looks. Like, look at this. Look at this. Who about to sit down for hours for some plaits? Not me. So y'all, I am loving this. I thought it was gonna be heavy, but it's not heavy at all, really. Y'all, I'm loving this. I'm loving this, okay? Look at these baby hairs. Look at how neat the plaits are, y'all. Now you can pretty much style them how you want. You see, it's, you know, it's several styles you can do. Alright y'all, so that is it for today's video. I hope y'all like, comment, and subscribe to my channel for more videos. And I will see y'all next video.